Welcome back, guys. This is Mr. Manasses Nganga from Kenya, and today I'm going to show you a new system. This library system, a graphic one. It is very smart. So we are going to start. Since this is the login page, put admin, then you will log in. So this is the new system. These are the tabs. If you want to add books, borrowers, borrow books, return books, overdues, there is the category part. Manage users, you can manage who will use this system, and you can get the reports. So let's start with the books. If you want to add a new book, you will add it through these tabs. Let's say you want to add a new book. I'll take a random book. You add the accession number, it is FPT006. The book title, it is Poems from East Africa. Poems from East Africa. Yeah, the secondary title, this book doesn't have, so I'm going to use this one. The author of the book, David Cook. The editor, there are various, just put various. The pages, 190. The publisher, East Africa Educational Publishers. And the category, it is for drama, poetry. Yeah, it is poetry. Then edition 2016. Type of book, this is non-reference. This means the reference books can't be borrowed, and the non-reference, they are the one to be borrowed by the borrowers. So language, it is English. Date published, you can just leave it empty, or maybe if you have the exact date, you can add, then you save. The book have been added in the database. So when you scroll this, you'll get the book down here. So this is the book. Maybe the edition, I used the wrong edition. So you delete. Yeah, I mean, we want to update the information. You can update anything in these fields. So maybe we put device. Then you will click update. We'll update the book information in the database. See, it is revised. Again, if you have tons of books in your library, you can search. You will use this search bar. So you can search through the with the accession number or anything. Book title, secondary title, maybe. Let me search an atlas. I want atlas. Atlas, yeah. See, there are two atlases here. Macmillan, primary atlas, and the atlas, Phillips. So this part, it is to add a new book, to update a new book, or maybe if you want to delete the book from the database, from the library database, you can do it with this part. We can go to the borrowers. This way you will add the borrower details, update, or maybe to delete the borrower from the library. Maybe you doesn't want him anymore, like that. You can print the library card. Yeah, this is the part for borrowers. To borrow books, this way you will borrow your book. Maybe let's say I want to borrow a book. It is for poems. So just write poems. Yeah, it will bring the book. You click the book, you add. It will bring you this list. You confirm the details of the book. Then borrower ID, you click find. If there are so many borrowers, you can search. Then you select the borrower. See, it will bring the details. And the time I want to borrow the book. Maybe I want it for 3 weeks. Yeah. You can pick 3 weeks, then you borrow, then the book has been borrowed. So when you go to history, there is this tab here, history. You will get the history of the books borrowed, maybe every day or so. Yeah. Today, it is 9th March. So, date borrowed, 9th March. Due date, see, 3 weeks. Between date borrowed and due date, it is 3 weeks. Copies, I took one copy. Secondary title, this is the title. Yes, you can search maybe a specific poems. Yeah, you'll get it, this one. FTP, you can search like that. So, this is the part for to borrow books. If you go back to books, then you scroll down, it was for poems. When you check the status, it is not available because I borrowed. Because it is already borrowed, so it is not available. You can't borrow a book twice. So that's for borrow books. So maybe I want to return a book. These are the history for returned books. So I'll check the books that I've borrowed. My borrower ID, it is here. 8563. So I'll put here my borrower ID, 8563. Then it will bring all the list of books that I've borrowed. This is the list. So you'll click the book. It will autofill these details: borrower name, book title, secondary title, author, date borrowed, time. Then I return. You return the book. It is returned now. When you go to history, you will see books returned today. They are here. 9th April, I returned this book at this time. 11:20, I returned the book. So when you go to books, let me update. Then you type poem, you will see status, it is available now. So I have returned the book, so someone can come and borrow, can borrow it again. So that is the part for returning books, the overdue books. People who have not followed who did not return books on time, these are their part. Overdue books, if you want to charge them, you can charge them per day, the tender amount, then you save. It will still save in the database. It will still tell you the list of the overdue books here. So there is a category of books. You can use shelves or so, yeah. You can use everything you want. So this system is just simple. It is very simple to use. This is the users to use this system. To log in, and maybe there is 3 people: librarian, administrator, and assistant. I logged in as administrator, that's why I can add books. If I'm the librarian, I'll just borrow, return, and overdue. The assistant will just, it is just the same as a librarian. So this part, I think we are done. We go to reports. In a report, you can get the list of the total books. The list of the total books in the library. So this is the list of all the books. Go to the last page. See, list of books. You can print, you can export as PDF, PDF, Microsoft Word, or Excel. So you can export. Again, you can print. You can print the whole pages. There are 2. I've not added a lot of books. Again, you can get total number of books. So this is the total number of books. There are 20. Total number of books, there are 20. You can check the books borrowed over a day. A whole day, the books borrowed in a day. So these are the books. Book title, this borrower, see, due date. You can take maybe weekly, yeah. I mean, usually monthly, only me. Maybe you can take returned books daily. I returned the book. Date borrowed, description, you can see even date returned. So you can check the weekly, monthly, returned books, overdue, just the same daily. There are no overdues. You can use even date filter. To filter, maybe you want an yearly, maybe in 3 months, let's say take start date. Let's start maybe from January January 1st to today. I have the borrowed books over this period of time. Then you click, yeah. So from January, these are the books that are borrowed from January. You can check returned. Using this date filter, you will filter the amount, the time that you want to filter the status. Maybe returned, overdue, like that. Just click preview. Just simple. You can print, export, or so. So that's it for this library system. As you can see, it is very smart, user friendly, easy to use. You can get it. You can get it from me. If you want it, you can visit my website. Go to the search bar. This is my website. I create websites, systems. If you want anything, you can check me out. This is my website. So this is my website. You can check me out. This is my website. If you want an awesome website like this one, you can contact me. These are my systems, the ones I've developed. You can view them here. Yeah, this is what my clients say. I've created a lot of systems. Yeah, you can contact me through this. This is my email, admin@manasesnganga.com. Thank you. That's it for today. See you again. Follow me on Twitter.